Senate Democrats decided to proceed into the wee hours of the morning, a maneuver usually reserved for controversial measures like awarding themselves pay raises, to pass an all-encompassing criminal justice bill that caters to offenders at the expenses of the law-abiding public. The Commonwealth's majority party apparently believed it was necessary to plow through more than 160 amendments, which often sparked heated debate, in one session that lasted until around 1:30 Friday morning, rather than expose the questionable contents of this legislation to the light of day. The key elements of the Senate bill, which finally passed on a 27-10 vote, would repeal mandatory minimum prison sentences for several drug-dealing crimes such as selling heroin within 300 feet of a school, make those changes retroactive, so dealers could seek early release from their prison sentences, legalize sexual relations between young teens close in age, and reassign 18-year-olds to the juvenile justice system, thus raising the age of criminal responsibility to 19, the highest in the nation. We applaud State Senator Eileen Donahue of Lowell, as well as three of her Democrat colleagues, for joining the six Republican senators in opposing this flawed bill. Senate progressives obviously believe that such a wholesale upending of the status quo will essentially give those who they believe disproportionately suffer under the current justice system a second chance. At whose expense? That's what victims of crimes and other Massachusetts residents should be asking. That's also the concern of the law enforcement community, which believes these radical departures from the current norm would erode all the gains made in curbing violent crime over the last few decades. 9 of the state's 11 district attorneys made that point in a letter to Senate leadership earlier in the week. Their letter includes a question virtually every Massachusetts citizen would like the answer to: where exactly are the residents eager for violent drug traffickers to be returned to their neighborhoods? This bill is long on left-wing ideology and short on practicality. Its backers assert it will help alleviate the overcrowding in our prison system, even though Massachusetts has the second lowest imprisonment rate in the nation, according to the Federal Bureau of Justice Statistics. And citing studies that show that adolescent brains aren't fully formed, this bill seeks to relieve all but the most violent 18-year-olds of the responsibility for their actions by assigning them juvenile status. Then perhaps 18-year-olds shouldn't be allowed to vote, sign contracts, and serve in the military, since having reached the age of majority, they can all legally do. Space doesn't allow us to detail all of this bill's deficiencies. We trust members of the House will exercise the common sense the Senate lacks and produce a more balanced, reasoned alternative to this legislation by keeping the public safety as its top priority.